Hey guys, Songo here with another playthrough of Fate of the World. The last bit of the last episode was actually lost in editing or something, which kind of sucks. Oh well, I even. Anyway, so I turned off the music because it was rather obnoxiously loud. And it was already as low as it can go. And now it's really eerily silent. So, we're in the year 2055, and we've got some stuff to be doing. Oh, but, actually, I already spent all my money for this turn. And didn't actually progress this turn because I. Anyway, let's move on to the next turn because that bit was lost in recording. So, let's try and end this late. Okay. So, we're running short on oil. We saw this coming. Oh, look, Japan is now war-torn and has finally opened its doors to me. Yay. Ingrates. Freaking ingrates. All I did was rig your elections. You didn't need to ban me from the country. Seriously. Well, Russia's pollution has gone down. That's good. So, this. Series has got an exceptionally low number of views. Like, even less than my music videos, which is rather surprising. This is actually a pretty fun game, and has a lot of in-depth, oh wow. I'm gonna immediately lose Japan again. Well. You guys just stick here for a while? Anyway, they're only 4% of the GDP. I don't need them. What's going on here? Well. Apparently, people do not like me here. That's not great. Yeah, I figured out what this contentment is and how it's different from support. Basically, contentment is some sort of factor that goes into them protesting you. And you can't control it directly. Meanwhile, support is influenced by support cards. So let's see. They are probably having a little bit of water stress. Sure. Yeah. Giving them nuclear power could be nice, but I want to improve their support for me so I can tax them, basically. So, as I was saying before I got all into that stuff, okay. This series is not going well, so let's try and end this in one massive episode. It will probably get even fewer views. That's sad. Okay, so how is So where's their actual So food for per capita. Yeah, that's just been going down. And genuine famine. They actually have famine. It's not some political bullshit. It's... Oh, no. It is political bullshit. This is their projected, place. Predicted amount. So what the hell is going on? They are suffering from famine, but is it because they're unemployed? Well, that's not a good sign. Apparently, I managed to increase unemployment to from 0% to 8.3% in 5 years, or 10 years rather. And 10% of the population is sick. That is inconvenient. They should be altruistic, which should, like, reduce this... let's see what we can do about this. Increases in employment and, contentment. And let's grow agriculture, because we don't want people dying of famine. Latin America. Deforestation halted. Yay! And we saved them from cataclysm. That's right, World of Warcraft never released in Latin America. We are saviors. That's such a stale joke. Anyway, looks like South Asia is unstable, which was what I'm looking for, so I'll provide security assistance. And give them higher education. Oh, and I was incorrect with smart grids. Apparently, smart grids actually do nothing, despite what it says here. It's just a centerpiece, a stepping stone towards the next technologies. So, yeah. Okay, North America, let's have you actually researching. I think you guys are researching energy? No, materials. Then where did we get all of the energy? Yeah, whatever. No, I think it's information that North America... Okay, fuck it. I'm choosing information. Latin America. Water stress is not anything difficult. 9.1% of them are unemployed. That's... not great. Let's give them medical welfare. Any 13% water stress. That's not much. Let's see if I can't actually focus on the guys who have big problems. Like this. Wow. That's a pretty significant change. So, Middle East. You've got some problems, right? Turning to gas? Well, considering we are... natural gas, not oil. Derp. I forget this is a British game. Yeah, they've still got water stress. So let's enhance their water infrastructure. And... Well, I'm honestly kind of lost as to what to do. Right. Deploying. What's your water stress? 13%. I'll use that money to instead use temporary measures and deploy sulfate aerosols. Which, by the way, I did make a slight mistake in converting everyone to a green outlook, or almost everyone, because look at the approval hit that sulfate aerosols gives me in green countries versus that's giving me a lot of support in consumerist countries. And since that's kind of your main way to delay the inevitable, well, yeah. I kind of shot myself in the foot there. Okay, I don't think there's too much more I can do right here. Perhaps grow some industry, but don't really need it. Let's just move on. And cool, we did decrease emissions and the projected temperature is going down. Next, Arctic methane gets worse. That's actually really bad. I think there are only three stages and we've now hit the second one. So, yeah. Fuck! I was trying so hard to prevent financial collapse. And this is where we go into a death spiral. And famine and politics. Yeah. And now there's war in Japan. Yep. Called it. Okay, fine, Japan. I'll fix your bloody problems. With only $50. The children in Japan don't know what job means. Did you try teaching them English? Famine and politics. Famine relief diverted to war in Japan. Diverted to war? Oh, okay, the efforts. Poverty ravaged Japan turns on Zongo. Yeah, You know, you guys probably should not be producing biofuel when you, like, have a famine problem, but whatever. So, North America, where things are at least slightly, decent. Let's grow industry. Because we need to decrease commerce in order to, like, get out of this recession thing. Which is actually gonna be really. This is going to significantly hinder us. So yeah. And now Latin America has turned unstable. Somewhat unsurprising. So let's check the progress. Reforestation has initiated. Yay. Okay. Southern Africa is doing better than you, Latin America. You should feel bad for yourselves. So, afforestation project starts. Emissions outrage rising in Southern Africa. Because they have a green outlook, so. You know what? Cap and trade carbon emissions is actually a pretty decent investment. If you can actually get people to commit to it. Okay, I'm taxing Europe because I really need money. So screw the eco-awareness campaign, cap and trade. Carbon. This is probably gonna get me kicked out of Russia. Nah. Ecologists praise Geo. Reforestation begins. Okay, well, where are here? Only 2,100 emissions. You're not important. So agriculture and industry are heavily undersupplied. So, yeah. We can actually solve this problem by building an energy office and, like, telling them to stop using oil and energy, which will indirectly increase other sources of energy. So, that actually sounds like a decent plan. I'll also bid for a Geo headquarters here because a very dangerous technology is undoubtedly going to be starting to get researched soon, if it has not already. The game do Okay, well, never mind. The game does tell you, when stuff like actually, okay, shut up. When you've actually got this stuff, what is it? Technology, yes. And right, I didn't have Japan because reasons, and so they weren't researching robotics. So I'm actually probably fine and could use this in other places. Let's see here. That's fine. You don't have much GDP anyway. 11%, 13%. Hold on. Latin America has less GDP than, or more GDP than North America. How did that happen? Okay. Well, no, it's not the distribution of. Huh. Anyway. So. How about we grow industry since that's going to be valuable here? And stuff. You know, it's really eerie that this game does that. I had to. That. There's no music because I turned it off. Kind of feels odd. Okay, so Middle East is unstable. That's a top priority. So I guess you're not committing to renewables this turn. It's kind of odd that countries here have, like, don't commit to renewables on their own or any other source of energy. You know, even when they lack all the oil that they need for. Yeah, it's odd. So, South Asia. It's fine. So, let's see. Oh, I've only got $10. That's a fine distribution. Now let's move on and hope we get a little bit more money. Dropped, transport energy. Bloody hell. And I ended the financial crisis in just 5 years. I think that's a new record. Although it really sucks for that turn, but still. And yeah. And now the two-humped Bactrian camel no longer exists. Fuck you, Japan. You know what? We don't need robotics. Screw you. Screw you and your mechas. And so, since we've got headquarters in China, we've got this golden little border thing, or fill, or whatever. And, okay. So, let's see what we can't do here. We've actually got very little cash, regardless of not being in a recession, I guess. So cap and trade carbon is going to be nice to reduce this country's horrible, horrible, pollution problems. So, speaking of, we didn't implement that here, but they are at least stable. And we fought the Latin American wildfires. That's good. Okay. Well, sure. Is there still famine going on? Thankfully, no. Just gonna be taxing them as well. Oh, right. This is a pretty good part of why there's so little, you know. Money coming in. There's just no resources available for the current economy. I really wish I could tax Africa. Like, seriously. So, let's see. Very low emissions. Incredibly high water stress. Let's see if... Wow. I guess, environmental protection here wasn't exactly top priority. Okay. So, let's see. Gems, da-da-da-da-da. Okay. So, is there anywhere I've... Okay, yes. So, let's decline... oil power, which will free up some oil for, like, industry and agriculture, and hopefully we get a little bit more money coming in, as well as hopefully pushing us towards, like, you know, reasonable, less polluting, like, energy sources. Like, I don't know, wind, solar, that stuff. We're at the point where committing to nuclear doesn't even make sense. Because, yeah. How many trees do you even have? Ah, that's fine. Okay, so, since this is our headquarters, Let's actually see if we can't improve the water stress situation. And there's famine going on. I don't know how. There should be plenty of food. Oh, unemployment. And a massive amount of sickness. Well, kind of to be expected when you're the most polluting, like, nation in the world. So, yeah. That sounds like a bad idea. So let's stop committing to nuclear and instead try and do some. No, that's too expensive. But could be useful. Now let's just switch transport to electricity since we are working to commit to renewables. Actually, first, let's see if we can't import technologies. Yeah. We don't need. Oops. That was really loud. Let's acquire fourth generation. Okay. Second gen biofuels. Because why not? No. That's not an efficient research. Let's just acquire fourth generation nuclear, because I think they advance it very slowly, even if I'm not advancing it myself. I may be wrong on that. Optimal, okay, cool. You know, Russia is actually doing what I'm asking pretty well. So, and I've got $36. Do you need any help in? No, you don't. I have a really bad memory for this stuff. Let's relieve some transport stress. That sounds like a good idea. And move on to 2070. Emissions are going down, but heat is still going up. Fucking financial collapse! And uranium peaked, as I said. And now rhinos go extinct. I think I found out why the financial market crashed. Because I limited China's production by roughly 40% with carbon capture and sequestration. So, since they made up the largest amount of the, like, industry and such, and that was what was holding up everyone's economy, when their productivity dropped, it collapsed everyone. Wow, so many mistakes being made. But, you know what? China likes us, so why not? And now I'm in debt of $68. Let's see if we can't free up a little bit of this money. We don't need to protect the trees here, I guess. And we don't need even dark green. Oh. That doesn't sound good. They aren't militaristic, so I wonder what dark green means. I thought there were only two, like... interesting. I thought there were only two levels above and below even outlook, though. And now I can't... It's Tobin tax. That sucks. Yeah. Do you still need a forestation manually? Probably, but I don't have money for it. You could really use some industry, but what we really need to do right now is to decrease oil power everywhere, to extend our very, very limited oil supply to where it's needed, which is agriculture and industry. Because us not having this, these supplies for those two are pushing people into, how to say, oh, these are global bans. Can I global, reduce nuclear, oil power? Oh, no. Just global ban. Okay. And that's kind of the entire point of us building a headquarters here, so we can ban clathrate exploitation. At least for now. But anyway. So, where is it? Decline oil power. Okay. I should probably stop cap and trade. No. Capture CSS. Okay. And we'll decline oil power so that there's oil for other places. Climate refugees. Okay. Yeah, that's kind of to be expected. And this place has finally gone unstable. You failed me, Oceania. So yeah. We're probably going to lose them, but at least we'll have a political office so we can stabilize them as soon as they come out. Next time. Actually, No, these are still communal, but this is materialist. So, I don't have the technology here at all. So, no, I can't. If this... Yeah, I probably made a pretty huge mistake in converting everyone to green. Because I can't deploy this anymore. Especially not in places where I can tax. So job sharing completes. That's good. Reduces ecological... I don't... Well... We could do synthetic oils, but... I think this is actually considered to be really underpowered. We don't really... Okay, vegetarian revolution. It seems like a cheap and easy way to reduce some of the stress on agriculture right now. How did I unlock this stuff? Let me check. Well, first of all, let's decline oil power. Fuck the industry, decline oil power. Yeah. Is there anything I can actually give up? Is it really worth cap and trade carbon emissions during a recession? A financial collapse? I've got it unlocked here. Is it because I have a energy sector? I did not know that. I've played like 10 playthroughs, and I did not know that. Yeah, I think it might be. Huh. That's actually... And these are incredibly efficient, like, stuff, cards. So, yeah, I'm definitely going to be using them. Going to regulate industry and, household carbon. Oh, is it... because of cap and trade carbon. Oh. Wait. So then that would mean that. Yes. It's because of cap and trade. I actually forget how these work. Who I can and tax Russia. There we go. So, now that cap and trade is no longer done, will it keep going? I'm going to test it out in here. So, synthetic oils for now, and vegetarian revolution, and, International Space Program, because that's definitely what I should be investing right now, in right now. And let's... Synthetic Oil Thingies Program. I'm kind of panicking right now. Kind of. You don't need that, you don't need that. Let's subsidize biochar, which captures carbon and puts it into agriculture. Ah. Okay. Oh. So. Sorry, I'll fix your problem next turn. Our emissions are at least going down. Yay. Okay, it feels like it's been a while, but, fuck you, India. I now have to deal with your war during a financial crisis and world food. Yay, photovoltaic. So much famine! Oh my god.
Oh wow.
Oh god. So, everyone's starving to death because there's no oil for, like, anything. Any, like, industry or agriculture to go on, and there's no actual, like, and that spent almost all my money. Fantastic. Oh, looks like they are now at minimum oil power. Yeah. They are using it entirely in transportation. But now we are running out of other resources. These guys are pleased right now, so actually we don't need to do anything here necessarily. I can't stop taxing because if I do, I won't be able to do anything. Hmm. Okay. Yeah, he called just praise Geo. Well, I'm doing it all I can. Do you have water problems? No. You've not really been having any storm problems either. I really don't need to do much to this, I think. Yeah. If I decreased oil use here, that would be useful, but I don't think I've got the luxury of expanding here. Do I not have it anywhere? No. Decline oil power, and if we can find the money. Awesome. I think we just found the nope, we're $1 off, derp. So, that sucks. Yay, World Forest Trees obligations. Know what? What we need to do is grow agriculture. Because everyone is fucking starving. Grow agriculture. Screw the industry. We are switching to entirely, Stone Age shit. Because we are running out of all of our materials and stuff. This will actually be incredibly necessary. Super tensile materials increases our renewable energies, which consequently increases what we've got available for other, like, areas. And I'm gonna need to provide a security assistance somehow. Always $1 off. So. Well, at least their tech is on the rise. That's good. Oh, right, anarchy. I forgot. And it'll take 100 to stop that. Know what? I could just go ahead and kill them all off to stop the war. That doesn't sound like a very good plan. Okay. No more committing to renewables, I guess. Because we actually. No more synthetic oils either, because we have a chance to declare martial law. And I don't see anywhere where we can actually. Well, I guess we can stop committing to renewables, kind of. For now, at least. So, yeah. This is not going well. Let's give them a medical welfare program. Because hopefully that helps. We're all going to die. A slow and hungry death. Financial crisis continues. And I'm bound. Banned from. Yeah, I'm boned as well, but I'm banned from Oceania. So, yeah. At least China likes me. Oh, and North Africa. Oh, and I've actually got quite a bit of money. Will you continue to let me tax you? Let's see the last. Nope. But yeah. Okay. I can't keep taxing them. But I think we are doing pretty well, all things considered. Considering we're in a deep famine crisis of epic proportions on a global scale. So, yeah. They are displeased, reasonably so. Yeah. Can't do that. So, subsidize biochar to increase their agriculture. And Latin America, what can I do to help you? Apparently, nothing. I think I literally did this last turn and they are still unstable. Okay, is there something? Know what? Growing into agriculture seems like a decent idea, and regional energy office, so that I can stop or start getting them to stop using oil. Gonna need that really bad here as well. Yeah. And you? Let's expand oil. Do you even have any potential oil? Yeah, they've still got quite a bit. In fact, a lot. Yeah. That'll last us another decade or two. Maybe three. If we can manage to, like, really start sorting this out. Problem is now the energy sector, which is the first sector to use up the supplies, itself is having shortages. So this isn't great. So can we acquire photovoltaic cells and super tensile materials? These both greatly improve the rate of renewables, and that's an actual fact. Unlike smart grids, which actually do jack shit. Okay, Russia. I think you can still get a little bit of gas. Not much, but it's gonna be something. So since we've got a... Damn it, I couldn't... Well, so yeah. Agriculture is slowly improving here. Still unstable here. So... Can I free up $50? Probably. Possibly not. Well, if I want to slow China's research a little bit, and though their energy deal is kind of, but I can't let India fall into anarchy. So, no. So, moving on to 2085. We've made it 9 years, or 90 years. And we're nearly at 3 degrees. No! Global crisis continues. So yeah. Japan. I'm kind of having problems of my own, in case you can't tell. Oh, very unstable. And guess what? The Middle East was flooded. It's a freaking miracle. Although it's not very much for the ones actually surviving. And still very unstable. And we've still got Japan to worry about. But we've at least got a political office here. Oh, bloody hell. This is getting kind of stressful. So, one big epic episode where we somehow finish this in either ice or fire, likely fire, very, very hot fire, fire, fire. It does not feel like I'm pronouncing that correctly. So, like, yeah. You're actually completely fine. Africa is the continent that's like is doing the best of all of them. Well, except for Latin America, which is actually doing pretty decently themselves, all things considered. You really need to stop consuming so much oil, though. So, can we possibly decline oil power? No, we're always $1 short. One. Just one. That's it. Okay, so these guys are content. Yeah. So, stop growing agriculture. We need to decline oil power. And I don't really have much money for anything else. Yeah. This is going to hurt quite a bit. Can't actually do anything with just $9. So let's move on and hope for the best. Ah, bloody hell. Just broke the third layer of Arctic methane. I think we lose. Ah, bloody hell. Yep. 2.5 degrees of warming. Still having a global financial crisis. Quantum computing breakthrough in North Africa. North Africa is advancing tech faster than the rest of the world. Let that just sink in for a little bit. What? You didn't have access to cath. Fuck, okay. Well, at least we haven't bursted, Arctic methane yet. I could have sworn I checked and saw that there was no clath rates available. Oh. They weren't part of Geo anymore. That's why. Bastards! You're sabotaging the entire planet! What the hell are you doing? Wow. Ugh. We're all gonna die. There's just no. Oh, God. Now, let's go to global view and look at what that actually is. Healthcare buckling in China. Storm devastates parts of Russia. Ecologists approve of geo, though. Poverty ravage Europe turns on Songo. No, stay in your freaking area. You abandon me. I tried and help you. Yay. Well, at least I'm getting thumbs up. So, did anyone let me back in? Nope. Nope. So still unstable. We're gonna have to provide security assistance. Same here. And this is kind of the food center of the world right now. Actually, let me just double check that statement. Yeah, 720 billion in agriculture here. Only 396 billion. And North America is only 60 billion in agriculture. This really sucks. We cannot afford to lose South Asia. Is there anything I can do? Okay. Second gen biofuels. I forgot that agents cost money. Because this would reduce the effect that biofuels had on their economy, on their food supply, and this is kind of necessary. I intended to get this long ago, but then I ran into money problems. So yeah. Russia. Virtually no agriculture. So let's see if we can't start improving how much you are taking out of the ground and decrease how much you are using here. So decline oil power. $8 short. That's fine, that's fine. I don't want to. So. Well, actually, let's look at the actual shortages. We've dropped the oil shortages to only 22% in both of these. So that's pretty good. Let's decline oil power even further. We can probably encourage coal mining. No, there's no potential. Yeah, they've got absolutely no coal to mine. Ah, and you? Very little. It's not going to be worth anything to try and extract it. So let's just see about how much you're using. 1,000 units, that's not bad. Coal. Entirely used by energy. So not great. Oh, and for synthetic oil. Oh, these are synthetic oils. Okay. Well, I guess. Coal to oil. Okay, yeah. Okay. Anyway, so, yeah. And Southern Africa is losing a lot of their force. Well, considering there is a wildfire, it kind of makes sense. Anyway, so, nothing I can do. I'm out of... Actually, I can expand agriculture a little bit. Latin America now has 20% of the world's GDP. If only I could... But, just grow agriculture. And we've made it 100 years and we're about to die. Yay, Europe. And there goes the Arctic methane. Now there is absolutely no chance to, like, come back from this. So, political famine. Well, welcome to the rest of the world. Welcome to the rest of the world. We have real famine. Get used to it. Well, we probably don't have real famine at this very moment. Looks like Latin America was just struck by a lot of storms. Oh, no, just poverty. Well, if I lose Latin America, I lose 20% of my money, so that's not great. Industry undersupplied. Let's see. Where is your oil consumption coming in? Transport. So, switch. Is that going to actually be worthwhile? Oh, can't even do that. By the way, what I'm referencing is switching to electric cars. We don't have time to commit to renewables. Right now, our only hope is to actually use the artificial coolers, coolants. Like, it's the literally only way we can do anything. We can keep playing. But considering this is my final episode, perhaps I don't want to keep playing. An interesting thought. This will get me kicked out instantly. So I guess I don't tax and just deploy sulfate. Yeah. So Latin America is gonna fall. I've still got the Africas. And yeah, this isn't great. What can we do right now? What can we do? I don't think there is anything we can do. Because at this point, the death spiral has already started. You saw our emissions right there, over. And we basically had zero emissions. But at this point, we don't have the technology to come back. So yeah. I think it's this turn that we lose. So, stop growing agriculture. It's not really worth it for just 1% of the population, emissions, and GDP. You guys can fall into war. 4% of the GDP. Okay. Well, decline oil power, I guess. Because there, I think that's about all I can do. Job sharing initiative. Grow agriculture, and hope for the best. Oh, yes! We did it, sulfates! Financial crisis continues, and we got banned from Latin America, but it does not matter if we deployed sulfates and saved ourselves a single turn. What time is it? Wow. This is potentially... I now have no money because 20% of my economy just left. Also, they kind of don't approve of this. Actually, they completely approve because of the simple fact that, we were all gonna die. And we probably still are going to die. So let's check. Coal is now the problem. So, can we do coal-free industry? Not right now. Cool. And that's nice. But you don't... Oh, you do have technology. And... Basically, we're going to be treading water a bit. Copes with changing weather and droughts. That's good. That's incredibly good. All things considered. Industry undersupplied because of coal. So let's move to coal-free industry. Which we cannot do. Unless we do this. And then coal-free industry, which moves all of the tasks onto electricity, and then we'll have problems there, but that's for later. I at least look like I'm doing something. We're decreasing the temperature. We're buying time. We've got advanced turbines. Clathrate eruption. I could have right, because it was discovered somewhere else. I am not notified when other countries got the technology. So I just have to straight up ban it from here, right now. Yeah. Oh, someone opened their doors to me. People whom I cannot support in any way. And very unstable. Bloody perfect. As I said, this game is kind of hard. Provide security assistance. I can't afford to lose the breadbasket of the entire freaking world. Funny how this happens. Advanced turbines. Cool. Let's check how much of your electricity is from renewables. 100%. Very good job. Too bad it's a bit late to make. No, it's not necessarily too late. industry is undersupplied, but agriculture is not. So we can still make this work. Okay, next turn. No more sea turtles, and some places have opened up their doors to me. Financial crisis still continues. Global oil production on the rise. Yay. Yes, you're welcome. Ungrateful. Banned from Europe? Oh well, I can't do anything for you. Thousands of people are dead, all famine victims, while tens of thousands are starving to death. But local leaders are too busy blaming each other to do anything about this humanitarian crisis. In a region torn apart by unrest, only one thing is certain: more will die. Yeah, I already accepted that. Russia has dropped their emissions dramatically. China has went from here to here. So that's nice. Over the course of like a century. So, yeah. Yeah. If only you've had the technology to like. But I don't have the money. Can I like, let's see. Where's your, you're not using coal at all. And you don't have any coal production. So, yeah. Okay. Well, let's see. Very stable. That's good. Yeah. Oh, this is actually decreasing it as I thought. Anyway, so they are probably experiencing a ton. Nope, not much water stress. Not much here either, so that's good as well. Agriculture. Okay. And let's. It's going to be needed, but like. Yeah. I don't have a bunch of money. And I need to keep that place producing a bunch of food. China is running out of coal. So, know what? Expand coal production. It's a temporary measure, but it's and if at all possible, we would have like done super tensile and that stuff and commit to renewables, but it's a bit late and like really late. No, it's never too late. Except when it is. Because only one person is producing sulfate geoengineering. And we're all gonna die. We've lived 20 years longer than I expected, admittedly. Yeah. Know what, you guys? I'm trying to focus on a couple of countries here. I can't deal with you and these guys, especially when my agents are just gonna die when you abandon me. Okay, so let's see. I've got $39. That's not really much to work with. I should probably... I should probably wrap it up here. It's getting pretty late, and it's kind of insensitive to my roommates. Well, it's about to end. Okay. Be right there. Okay, well, they must have accidentally hit the door. Never mind. So, yeah. There's not much I can actually do. Oh, 9% of the global economy? Let's expand your agriculture. And end turn. We are still decreasing, which is nice. And now I'm banned from North America. Well, yeah. Is there... I've got 132 that I can do. Commit to renewables. Deploy sulfates. oh yeah. Still a bunch of like major problems going on. Okay, I'm not gonna be deploying sulfates. That's kind of just delaying the inevitable. I'll just accept what comes and die fighting. Because this is the last episode. Coal is undersupplied. Come on, you should be, like, switching off of coal on your own. But that's kind of against the balance of the game. Our missions are actually dropping rather significantly. Oh, no. It's continuing to rise very slightly. And financial crisis ends at long, long last. 69 million. Ahaha. People have died from this. I can't believe that's all. Wow. So, yeah. This is... Actually, we could recover here. Resources greatly exceed global supply. That's fine. But money also, does not... I don't have enough money. Even after the whole, like... stuff where financial crisis ended, but no one's supporting me, so hey, I'm keeping peace as long as possible. I should have been committing more and more much earlier. Let's see if we can't raise welfare. That's about it. No, we can't increase agriculture and industry. So, yeah. And I'm about to pass 3 degrees. A lot of wars in Japan. Very historically accurate. I can't believe we have not lost yet. Like, wow. Green activists seeing red. Well, what the hell do you expect me to do about it? Why are you not committing to... Oh, are you as committed as possible? That's unfortunate. No jobs, no hope. Yeah. 51% are unemployed. 34 are sick. Yeah. We're kind of screwed right now, in case you haven't noticed. But grow agriculture and industry. And let's see if we can't job sharing initiative. Grow industry. No. They've still got a coal-powered industry. Or not. Oh well. Okay, grow industry. Where is it? Oh, derp. So, this has been a pretty long playthrough. I expected this to end much earlier. But this is the epic final episode. So, if you're still watching this, good for you. You don't have a life, I guess. So, yeah. Coal-free industry. And get a job-sharing initiative. There's undoubtedly a ton... Oh, 0% unemployment, wow. No wonder they're 9% of the entire world's GDP. Wow. So, yes. I honestly don't know what to do right now. $2 off from that. This is only $10. We can afford it. Let's just do it. So. And now, the final turn. Nope, I think I... Oh, yes. We've made it to exactly... Is it 3, or did we increase by 0? Make up your mind. Wow, this is really loud. I think we may have stabilized. Even if we are in complete shit, we may have stabilized. Emphasis on may. Not having any, like, Wildfire protection is really hurting the forests here. And that's actually rather significant. So, let's give them some protection. And start protecting you. Maybe. Acquire quantum computing. And then we've got 10 left. So let's see. We can give okay. Right now, we need you to be protected a little bit more than we need. No, probably not. Okay, there we go. 3 degrees of warming. And we lose. Oh, but financial crisis ends. And next. What? Don't we lose? Well, that problem. Okay. So, that's not the quest. Do we not lose? Let's go one more time. There. Huh. I may have a mission so damned low that I actually bugged out the game. So, anyway, that's a failed run at Fate of the World. I won't be uploading another video of this. And have fun.